Thank you.
Yeah. Actually, I represent the family who produces tequila that you're going to taste in there. I represent them for a long time. I'm very proud that they produce that tequila for almost 3 generations. They don't export tequila. This is like a very small production, but quality you're going to taste.
Okay.
I don't like to say nothing bad or negative against this tequila because it's not fair, it's not, how you say that, ethical?
Ethical.
I just call it like that, commercial tequila. Tequila is a Mexican tradition.
Mm-hmm.
For this family, it's very important to keep that tradition and the quality. The tequila you're going to taste in there definitely is not the one that you're going to find in liquor stores. It's absolutely organic and artisanal. It's also free. There is no shampoo in it. You can taste everything I have in there. Is that fine for you?
Yes.
Do you want to go for tasting?
Yes. I got one question. You answered it already, but I was surprised. That tequila comes from guave?
Agave. The plant. This is the plant give us tequila. And that plant in Mexico is the only one give us tequila because in Mexico we had at least 250 different agaves. There is another one, the leaves are bigger and more green. With that one, people produce mezcal. I don't know if you never heard about mezcal. Mezcal is the one that has a little warm sometimes.
Yes.
Oh.
Many people confuse mezcal with tequila, no, it's not the same. And this family don't produce mezcal. Mezcal is made different place in Mexico.
Okay.
South of Mexico, mezcal, tequila, center of Mexico. But you know that we have to wait 12 years to the agave grows and then process into tequila, long time.
Mm-hmm.
That's why I say to you before, there is 2 types of tequila, the commercial and the real made, absolutely 100% agave. I tell you something.
Okay.
The big companies normally, because they need so much production to export,
this
family don't export tequila. What are they going to do? First of all, which is terrible, they're going to put chemicals, using fertilizer in the soil to make the agave grow faster.
Right.
And they're not going to wait 12 years. And again, because they need so much production,
they're
going to mix different chapot agaves many times. And really, I hate to say that, because this is one of the reasons why many people don't like tequila. My goodness, I'm not surprised. This is not tequila. Like this. They use also sugar cane.
Yeah.
That's gonna get you the next day the terrible headache.
Right.
Sugars, chemicals in that tequila.
Yeah.
Authentic tequila made absolutely 100% agave guarantee. And I'm serious. Don't get you that. At least we drink tomorrow for one night. You know tequila is considered one of the most healthy alcohol beverages.
Oh, wow.
I explain you why. You can read about it.
Mm-hmm.
You don't believe it. You can read about it. Remember tequila became from the plant. That plant has many properties. 100% blue agave tequila. That is very good for joints problems. Me too, honey.
Wow.
I started, you know, I'm a woman.
Me too.
My toe. It hurts. One shot. Tell me. I'm not going to say, because I like to be in it, because I'm not going to kill you.
Yeah,
but,
of course.
But healthy, good for the pain.
Well, you feel good. So you
good for the pain,
so you don't
also.
Pain.
No, but also has many, how you say, for people who have like a high blood pressure, a little bit, not a whole bar, a little bit immediately regulated.
That's good.
But has many, how you say that?
Properties?
Probiotics. Yes. That's why Mexicans, we drink a shot of tequila after dinner before lunch, because we don't want to store.
Okay.
But the most important, and I'm serious, I'm not kidding, is our Mexican Viagra.
Oh.
I'm serious.
Muchas gracias para
información. I don't think you need that, bro, but I'm serious. 100% blue agave tequila a little bit before. I don't know, show you something. When the agave is ready, there is one guy, actually this guy. That man, you can see it bigger over there. That man, we call it Jimado. That was his win. When the agave is ready, 12 years, he's cutting with a tool. He's cutting all the leaves around the plant because the only thing we use to produce tequila, my friends, not the roots, not the leaves. It's just the center of the agave. Look like a big pineapple, as you can see.
Ah, okay.
See what I mean? Sometimes those pineapples can weigh like 150 kilos.
Wow.
Push like that, but please listen. For every 20, 25 kilos, more or less, of course, we produce uno, just 1 liter of that, 1 liter of chicken, not much. Again, when tequila is made 100% agave, this is a huge difference between commercial tequila and real tequila. Okay? So the second step in the process, those pineapples, we have to cook it. As you can see, we have an oven over there, but that is only a replica because everything is made in the factory.
Yes.
So we cook the agaves by steam, we steam it, like vegetables, if I can say that. And that process, it takes such a long time. This one, it takes at least 3 days. Again, my brothers, I'm talking about artisanal tequila. Otherwise, the big companies, they use ovens, electronic, like a microwave, push a button in 1 hour. This is a good eater for tequila. Has to be cooked slowly, much slow. That food was another thing, you know. So once the agaves are already cooked, they became tender, juicy, and very sweet. Those are full of nectar. I don't know if you never heard about agave syrup, agave nectar.
Yes. Yep.
Yes. If you had the opportunity to use it. You know, my friends, sugar, regular sugar in general is not good for our body. It's almost poison.
Correct.
Agave nectar or syrup is very good for everybody, but especially for people, I must say, like me, I have diabetes. The only thing I can use as a sugar substitute is agave nectar. Why? Because almost no glucose. And very low in calories, which is fantastic.
Wow.
Over coffee, pancakes, see, you know what?
See, I used to use that. We got to get back to that.
Yeah. I use it also like a sweetness for my margaritas. I promise my margaritas are delicious. So once the agave is already cooked, we have to cut it in 4 pieces and then we take it to this place. Aquí en mi home, to this place, because we have to smash it without the stone.
Smash it with that stone.
We make tequila same way people made or used to make moonshine. Now we're talking, right? We smash agave without a stone. And then you can go from that pool to a container right here. But only for 1 day, sometimes 7 nights, just rest and repose. After that, we have to take the juices out and we place it in another container, but this time for fermentation. That fermentation don't look nice, actually, but it's very strong. And we call it mosto. If somebody drink a little bit like that, I promise they're gonna be talking with the pantry over there. Fermentation, natural fermentation, 70% agave juice, 30% juice water. We don't use yeast. Why we don't use yeast? Because agaves are sweet, so it produces the warm fermentation. It depends on weather, about 20, 25 days later, the fermentation looks like that, like a bubble. That means it's ready to pass to the distillation process. Very important to let you know this word. This family made triple distillery, 3 times distillery, a lot, drop by drop, a lot of work, a lot of time, but the result is amazing. The tequila becomes very smooth, pure, clear. The big companies, again, because they need to speed the process, they make only 1 distillation. You will see the difference. After 3 distillations in Mexico, there is 4 types of tequilas, 4 categories. I'm going to show you. Mm-hmm. But look, my friend behind you, she wants to take to the welcome picture. It's
okay.
For you know why we do that? Because we always want to see the before and after the tequila.
Okay. Okay. Stay. Stay tuned for part 2. Tequila en Casa Mameco.
Tequila.
What's your name?
Sandra came to Mexico, drink tequila with us.
All right.